What's up, everybody? Wednesday, May the 25th, 2011. Middle of the week, Wednesday. Elimination day for the Oklahoma City Thunder going against the Dallas Mavericks in Dallas, Texas. Who's going to win it? Let me know what you think. Also, Mike Brown, former Cleveland Cavaliers coach, hired by the Lakers today. What you think about that? Check the caption box for information for all your needs, from t-shirts to release dates, real versus fake, and just general information on sneakers. Kixpo 2011, Dallas, Texas, at Dallas Cowboys Stadium in Irving, Texas, coming up soon on July the 2nd. Hope to see you there. I'm back with shoes 453, 454, and 455 out of 708. 709 is on the way. It's another PE, and it should be here hopefully by the end of the week or early next week. So that should be the next pickup for me that I'm anticipating. All right, let's jump off into these shoes. But one more thing. I had a question asked to me. Who do I think I influence more on the page, the younger viewers or the older viewers? I think I touch more of the older viewers, say 33 and above, who have knowledge or have seen a lot of the older shoes that I have. You know, I take them over the newer shoes any day. There are some newer shoes that I do like, and of course I'm still buying them, but I like the older shoes and a different variety of Jordan shoes. So I think mainly it's the older viewers, but hit me up, let me know. I mean, I know it's some younger people that are really into all styles and types of Jordan shoes. Don't get me wrong, but I think more people are just interested that are older. So hit me up. Let me know what you think about that. Let's jump off into these shoes. Before we do that, rest in peace up in Kenneth's Corner. Lights on, lights off. Here are some of the collectibles that I have, some figurines, starting lineups, the Hot Wheels bus with MJ, more starting lineups, Maximum Overdrive. I'm sure some people have had these back in the day. You know, the Wheaties boxes, the Upper Deck that came with the Jordan cards and stuff like that. The colognes, and things of that nature. We'll get more into this stuff a little bit later. This other stuff that I have been collecting over the years also. But shoe number 453 is another Jordan Classic 87. The white, the metallic silver, and light steel gray. 317-770-105. This is one of the three patent leathers that I have. The whole shoe is patent leather with your chrome Jumpman there on the side. 23 in the back, all whited out shoe. Here's your air unit, but inside the air unit is gray. No tinted windows on that. White laces, silver Jumpman. You got your gray and white interior with your gray Jumpman. And you have your lace tag there. And then we have another one. You remember the black and red from the other day? This is the Bumblebee colorway, as I like to call it. The white, the black, the varsity maze. 317-770-108. Another one from 2008 that retailed for $105. Your tumbled leather here. That's really, really soft, by the way. Your outsole. black and yellow. 23 in the back. Your air unit on the inside of it is a yellow. And your interior, yellow and black. Your ground effects or your insole is black with a yellow Jumpman. And shoe 455, the Jordan TGIM. I don't know if many of you know what the TGIM is or who wore these shoes. Back in 2008, it was a shoe worn by Ray Allen during the 2008 playoffs. It's a mixture of full grain leather and mesh with patent leather mixed in also. It has a non-marking outsole, meaning it won't leave marks on the court when you play. And it has great traction. And you can see the air unit. It's red on the inside and three different parts of the shoe. The outside, the back, and the inside. And you have your carbon fiber in there also. Your interior is red and black. And you have your insole that's black with the circle. And we know what that reminds us of. And here you can see your Jumpman engraved into the toe box area of the shoe, your patent leather, your laces, your 23. This is with lights on. Let's see what it looks like. Lights off. And then you have your red Jumpman here on the outside. So they doubled up with the Jumpman right here in the toe box area, and then right here in the ankle area of the shoe. Turn the lights back on. A little slight 3M on there. Let's take these straight to the foot game. All patents first. All right, here we go with the Bumblebees. And last but not least, the TGIM, which is The Game Is Mine, is what it stands for. There it is. All right, shoes 453, 454, and 455. The evening word is take the initiative and lead the way. You can make the difference. It's your boy Jumpman, fading to the back from the basement of the J's. I'll holler at you later. Peace.